mean it was stolen?
Just what I said. When I went to get it, it was gone.
Oh, I suppose you put it in a safe place.
Of course I did.
You're lying, Quinn.
No, I'm not. Look, I'll make it.
Doesn't matter. You're off the book.
Eh? But I made a go of it.
I don't do business with incompetents.
Oh, please, Miss Ferguson.
Forget it. Where you're going, you won't be worried about bookmaking.
What are you going to do with me?
Make a recommendation. I reckon you should be transferred.
Where to?
Another block.
You old bitch.
That does it.
Just a minute. What's going on? Quinn giving you trouble?
I think we should have a word with Quinn about her discipline. Right, back to work for the moment.
Yeah, well, we'll worry about her later. Now the governor would like to see us. The letter in the dispatch. Yeah.
How's the job going, Susie?
Fine, thanks, Mr. Strawn.
Fine? That's all?
Oh, no. Oh, the people are really nice to work with and all that. Only...
Only what?
Well, I was wondering if there was any overtime I could do. You see, I'm not doing so well on the money.
You get paid the same as everybody else. Union rates.
I realise that. But most of the others are at school or college. They only work here to earn part-time money. And, well, they live at home, so they don't have to pay rent.
But it's all you've got.
Yeah, I know. And by the time I've paid board and my fares, well, there's nothing left for anything else. Do you know what I mean?
Of course I do. And I think I can help you.
Oh, can you? I can work any time, and I don't mind what the roster's like.
Well, the roster wasn't exactly what I had in mind. I think we should get together after hours, work something out. You know?
He's after that again, is he?
Jack, what do you mean?
Old Strawn. It's a hard word just about every girl that works here.
Does he?
Yeah. You'd have to be pretty hard up, though, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I suppose you would.
The whole thing with Latham blew up because I told her I couldn't help her to see a child. Well, not on her terms, anyway.
So she told more lies to get back at him.
Well, it'd have to be very good to convince Smith. She's no fool, and she wrote the article.
But she will try and buck the system if she thinks she can get away with it.
Maybe she believes my alibi will break down.
Will it?
Well, Jane and I did spend a few minutes apart that night.
Yes, but not long enough for that to have happened.
Well, of course, I intend to speak to Smith and Latham, but I wanted to hear what you had to say first. Well, leave it with me, and thank you very much for coming in early, Mr. Faulkner. Who is it, Mrs. Powell?
A reporter to see you.
Oh, blast. Well, I suppose it had to happen. Would you bring Latham in, Miss Ferguson?
Of course, Governor.
I'll get Smith, if you like.
No, I don't think you ought to see either of them unless we're all present. Mrs. Powell, would you get Smith? Heather, if the reporter would like to wait, I'll see him as soon as I can. Thank you.
You just don't get transferred for nothing. She must have said something.
Not her.
You know, I reckon it was her that pinched the money.
Why?
Well, why not? She'd have no trouble getting rid of it. And there's no bloody way I'd accuse her of it.
She probably took my money as well.
Yeah, I reckon you've done that cold, Dor.
Rotten bitch. Speak of the devil.
You finished your meal, Latham?
Yes.
Good, because the governor wants to see you. Come on, move it. Before we go any further, I was just wondering about that little girl of yours.
Yeah? What about her?
Well, how much you really want to see her, for instance.
You know I do.
Badly?
Yes, badly.
Good. Because there's something I want you to do. And if you want to see that little girl of yours again, you'd better do as you're told.
He used to give me roses.
I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.